It is going to be a good day today. Heartland kids, we are taking over. So Pastor Dusty and Kendra, you guys can just go ahead, take the day off. We got it from here, okay? Thanks so much.
Yeah, and this is actually the service, the time in the service where we typically do our core values. So this side of the auditorium, we're going to do our first core value. No, I'm just kidding.
No,
we're not doing core values today.
We won't make you do our core values today, but we do hope that you are enjoying your Sunday morning with us. My name is Tiana. I have the pleasure of being our Heartland Kids director here at Heartland, and this is my wonderful husband, Chase. Man, it is the joy of our lives that we get to serve on this team and get to take care and love on all of your precious kiddos. And we have a very special day planned today. It is our Heartland Kids Christmas production. They have been working so hard, you guys, so hard over the last several months.
Yeah, that's right. And can't forget the parents, Tiana. Oh, I mean,
the parents.
They've been hearing bits and pieces of this.
Y'all are the real
month
MVPs,
after month, and
okay?
So we're finally putting it together. You know, one of my favorite things about this is that these kids aren't just memorizing these parts just to kind of perform, but they're actually getting to memorize scripture and learn scripture, and majority of their parts are the word,
sure,
which
yeah.
is really, really cool.
Yes, it is. And if this is your first year experiencing a production with us, we believe so strongly in the next generation. We have wonderful pastors that are just passionate about pouring into the next generation, so much so that they set aside an entire Sunday for us to celebrate our kiddos. And we have some special surprises in our production today. So we not only have kids, but we have a few other generations in here as well, which we are so excited about. For the first time ever, we're getting to include all of our next gen, and we are pumped. So we really believe that we want to provide a space for our kids to be able to grow and learn and develop the gifts that God has placed inside of them and have a safe place to do it where they can feel like they belong. So Heartland Church, you get to be a part of that today. So thank you so much for allowing us to do this and for helping us celebrate our kids this morning. We are just so excited.
Yeah, we are, and I think it's time that we let them show off what they got.
I think it's time for them to shine. Are you guys ready? All right. Well, Heartland Church, please help me welcome our Heartland Kids for our Heartland Kids Christmas production.
Who doesn't love Christmas lights? How many of you take a night to drive around town to look at all the beautiful light displays? There are some that are so extravagantly decorated with thousands of lights that it's absolutely breathtaking. But did you know that there is one light like nothing we have ever seen? A song lyric I've recently heard says, "A light that shines so bright it outshines the brightest lights of the world." This light is Jesus. Jesus himself said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." So lean in and listen up as Heartland Kids presents, "The Light Has Come."
Unto you a mighty Lord, unto you a light from Jesus came to us on that special night we now call Christmas because of the sin in every human heart. No one is able to go through the Father except through Jesus Christ.
John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only begotten Son, for whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. God had a plan to send Jesus Christ to be the Savior of the world.
Bethlehem is just a sleepy town, but it's the place salvation's coming down. In a little stable, simple as can be, Mary sings a welcome song to the King of Kings. What a wonderful night! Jesus Christ is born. The star is shining so bright. Come, let us adore. Glory to God in the highest. Peace to all of us. What a wonderful Savior, Jesus.
Bethlehem is baby Jesus' throne. God with us has found a humble home. In a little stable, in my little heart, when you find God's saving grace, that's when Christmas starts.
What a wonderful night! Jesus Christ is born. The star is shining so bright.
To him now. He is the one that frees us from all our fears. He is the reason we rejoice at Christmas and all year long. No matter what life brings us, we can always trust that Jesus will be with us.
Until the Son of God appears, rejoice. And it came to pass in those days that I went out from a decree from Caesar Augustus for all the world to be taxed. And Joseph went up to Galilee out of the city of Nazareth to Judah, onto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth for her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you this day is born in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Shepherds were in the fields that night. The sky opened up with angel light. They were afraid. A report was made. Unto you a child is born. If you go to Bethlehem on Christmas morn, you'll find him there. Heaven's glory share. So they bent to bow before the boy. Born to fill your hearts with joy. Noel, Noel, we bring praises to the King of the ages. Noel, Noel, come and see the newborn King. Noel. So there you're walking in the dark. The light has come to open up your heart. Don't be afraid. Jesus came to save. Unto you the Christmas joy. Christ will take your sin away if you believe. He will set you free. Come and bow before the baby boy, who was born to fill your hearts with joy. Noel, we bring praises to the King of the ages. Noel, Noel, come and see the noon with me. Noel, Noel, we bring praises to the King of the ages. Noel, Noel, come and see the newborn King. Noel. Love came down that Christmas, Christmas, doesn't tear with us. Noel, Noel, we bring praises to the King of the ages. Noel, Noel, come and see the young with me. Noel, Noel, we bring praises to the King of the ages. Noel, Noel, come and see the newborn King. Noel, Noel, come and see the newborn King. Noel, Noel, come and see the newborn King. Noel.
And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill toward men.
And the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even under Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart.
And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising the Lord for all those things they had seen and heard. And the name given to him by the angels was called Jesus.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. When a sinner puts faith and trust and gives their life and heart to Jesus Christ, that person becomes a child of God. He wants us to come to him as a child. Revelation 22:17 says, "The Spirit and the Bride say, 'Come,' and let the one who hears say, 'Come.' Let the one who is thirsty come, and let the one who wishes take the free gift of the water of life." Just as Romans 10:9 says, "If you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved."
Oh, When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judah in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, go search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring word to me again that I may worship him also.
When they had heard from the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them till it stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
And when they were coming into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother and fell down and worshipped him. When they opened the treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Happy birthday, Jesus.
Jesus' birth commands a response. Mary treasured and constantly thought about what had just happened. The shepherds glorified and praised God for all that they had saw and heard. The wise men and magi brought precious gifts in response to the birth of the king. But King Herod responded with hate throughout the life of Jesus. Many others responded with unbelief. Today, some still respond with unbelief and reject that Jesus was born of a virgin to live a perfect, sinless life, to die on a rugged cross for the sins of the world, to be buried, but to rise again to give hope to the world. How will you respond? Will you worship God alone? Will you praise the Lord for coming to give you hope? Will you put your trust and your faith in him? May we all be able to respond with a hallelujah, amen.
Joseph's tiny one, though how could it be that God would come? Alleluia, amen. The shepherds became the first to see how God would set his people.
Choose this day who you will serve. Will you serve the Lord Jesus or will you serve yourself?
Will you continue to walk in hopelessness or will you turn to the light? That is Jesus. Repent of your sins and ask him to save you, for he is the only one who can save us. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things are made by him. Without him was nothing made that was made. In him was life, and life was the light of men. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. So are you following Jesus, or are you still walking in the darkness of the world? Come into the light has come.
With
My goodness, can we give it up for our Heartland kids one more time? They did incredible. We are so proud of you. You guys can have a seat for a moment. I would love to invite my team up here with me, my lead team, Jill, Leah, Miss Marissa, and Miss McKenzie. As you guys know, it takes a lot of people to put something together like this. And so I would be remiss if I didn't take a moment to honor the incredible people that have said yes to helping build up our next generation. And so these ladies right here, they have given months of their time and their dedication and their gifts and passions. It makes me emotional because our kiddos get to learn from the best of the best right here. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for sharing the gifts that God has placed inside of you and seeing them in our kiddos and helping them develop those so that they can shine. Thank you so much. We honor you today. Thank you. Let's give it up for them one more time, guys. Thank you to our parents. You guys are a big deal to us at Heartland. We cannot do what we do without you. So I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart for every song you have practiced with them, every line you have rehearsed with them, the hours and hours you have put in. Thank you so much. Thank you to our incredible production team. You guys, we couldn't do this without you. Thank you to everyone involved. If I could stand up here and list every name, we would be here for a while, so I won't do that. But you know who you are. Thank you so much. And it is just an honor to be able to do this for our kiddos. And I thank you for supporting our kids in such a great way. So, Pastor Dusty, I would love to invite you to the stage.
And I want to give a big thank you to Tiana. Come on, do you love this lady very much? Yeah. Love you, T. Well, stand on your feet all over the room. Man, I loved that. So many little personalities that are going to become big personalities. Somebody said in our Slack thread, the future of Heartland worship is stacked. You know what I'm saying? Like we got them coming, baby. I'm ready. Well, it has been a real joy to have each and every one of you here. Maybe you're a grandparent or a friend or a relative that was invited to see a child today. I want to thank you for hanging out with us today here at HC. Such a thrill to have you here. And for those of you who are partners here at HC, thank you for your giving to the legacy offering. If you made a pledge, thanks for making sure that that gets in before the end of the year. And if you want to give today, there are boxes out in the hallways. We don't pass physical offering buckets at our church. But it's a real thrill to have you here today. And I hope that you have a great one. One more weekend before Christmas, and that's this coming week. It's a big weekend for our church with Giving Hope. Spirit fingers, here we go. It's going to be a good one. God bless you guys. Have a great day. And we will see you next Sunday.